Okay, good morning everybody. How are you? This is Ricardo with Phoenix Trading Strategies. Tonight is July 14th, 2016. It is 2 a.m. Eastern Time. We're going to be starting the Phoenix Trading Strategies Forecasting Room. Before we continue, let us go to the disclaimer. Get that out of the way. Disclaimer, future stocks and spot currency trading have large potential rewards, but also large potential risk. You must be aware of the risk and be willing to accept them in order to invest in future stocks and forex markets. Don't trade with money you can't afford to lose. This presentation website is neither a solicitation or an offer to buy or sell future stocks or forex. No representation is being made that any account will or is likely to achieve profits or losses similar to those discussed on this presentation or website. Past performance of indicators or methodology are not necessarily indicative of future results. Let's go to the calendar. It is Thursday and is a French bank holiday today. We have PPI numbers, producer price index numbers coming out for the Swiss franc. We also have later on this morning rate announcement for and monetary policy summary for the UK. And that's all the news that we have today. So right now, anything that we see currently trading will be primarily based on pure technicals. Now, being that said and done, you know, looking at the Euro trade right now as it is being displayed, they already initiated a trade to the upside, came down aggressively, and now looks to be the case that they may continue up. But I'm more interested in looking at the higher time frames right now to see if there's anything that we're missing based on this. So let's see if we can find something on the higher time frames. Nothing in the Dow futures, S&P looks to be the same, but it looks like they're playing off of a trend stop, so they could come down. NASDAQ, the Russell, same thing, nothing extravagant. The DAX, DAX is opening to the upside. They must, we'll see how they play out. They've been bullish for quite some time now. Crude looks like they're going to retrace and come back down. We have power deformation here in the 60 minutes, so it'll be interesting to see how it plays. Gold already came down. So that would tell us that we have U.S. dollar strength in place. That's not the trade that they're playing here. They've already played it, so it'll be interesting to see how it plays out. The Swissy looks like it's going to come down. So it seems like we're going to be losing dollar strength, and at least for the time being until the rate announcement from the U.K. Euro New Zealand already made a move. Very nice move from 52.53 to 54.22. Very, very 100 pip move. Euro yen looks like it's going to come down. It'll be interesting to see. Euro Swissy, undefined right now. Pound dollar looks like they're going to continue to go long. Euro pound, this one looks interesting. Looks like they're going to strengthen the euro against the British pound. So they must know something is up regarding the rate announcement. Pound Aussie also looks right now as if they're going to strengthen the pound. But for how long is the next question? Pound New Zealand, that one looks like it's going to come down or continue actually. Pound Swissy looks like it's going to be bullish. Pound Yen already broke through to the upside, so we'll see what happens here. New Zealand CAD. This one's been a very interesting trade, actually, and it has already made its move down quite a bit. New Zealand Dollar, nice trade to the upside to the trend stop, and then came crashing down. Great trade to look at. Aussie Yen or New Zealand Yen, nothing yet. Aussie Yen, still undefined, looks like they're going to bring it down. Aussie dollar already came down, so it'll be interesting to see how these trades actually manifest themselves. Let's go down to a 10 minute. And as you can see, the Aussie dollar already began its downtrend. It's come down 15 pips so far. Looks good. But we're a little late in that regard. I do like the Dow, but I don't like it to the upside. Today was came down, then it rallied up this morning. So it was a very interesting trade. And of course, came right back down to retest, and now it's up again. So this is currently trading off of the high. I like it to the downside. I don't like it to the upside, but it's not defined yet. So we'll have to wait on that. The DAX looks to rally to the upside. You know, this is usually a good indication that they are going to take it up. Just opened right now. Normally they retest a trend stop and then rally to the upside. So this trade looks good long, but right now I'm not completely sold on it. We are looking at crude. Crude has no definition right now. And gold. Gold is always very interesting. It always defines whether we're going to have dollar strength or weakness. I'm going to add a few more indicators here because I want to see what gold actually looks like. Let's give it a second. All right, so let's take a look at this. So they, as they came down, they retested here, didn't really come all the way up, and then continued to collapse. So this was practically from 1348 to 1334, almost a $13 move to the downside, very quick. Now, right now, based on what we see, I still see volume divergence to the downside, so I wouldn't really necessarily be trading gold to the upside yet. I would need it to come up quite a bit, actually come up to 1336, and then at that point set up a new level here before going long. So this one is not yet ready. Let's take a look at the US yen. We'll go over them one at a time. Give it a minute. Almost there. Come on. Okay. So this one already made its move up, but we have volume divergence. So this trade is no longer to the upside, but to the downside, and the volume divergence began here. So at this point, I would be very hesitant about continuing to trade this trade to the upside. Now, stop loss based on this would be questionable, and right now only because this is an inside bar and this next one's an inside bar, but I'm afraid that they'll make the rally one more time and then it'll change. So if it doesn't break above this where it's currently trading, then at that point I'd be interested in going short. Right now, not yet. I still think that it's still has to go up slightly, and I believe that we'll probably see an entry on the 5 minute. Let's go to the 5 minute real quickly. At least we've been able to identify volume divergence. Now we need to see how far it goes before it comes crashing down. Just give it a minute. Sometimes we just gotta take our time. Almost there. All right. So let's see this. See this candle right here, where the point of control announces that the buyers are going to stop offering to the upside, says a lot. You can see how this one here is still in divergence. So I believe this will be the last candle to the upside before they come down. I just want to see where it settles first, because that's where I'm going to be looking for an entry. See, this has negative volume down here. It's settling with negative volume, but it still has one more move to the upside, and that will probably be the last one. And let's take a look how far this thing has gone. It's gone from 104.07 to 105.46. That's a pretty big move. And I think this move is over right here. So here, I would be actually interested in going short. And my risk in this case would be here 105.50, so I would be risking 8 pips. That's as much as I'm willing to risk on this trade. Now, if it doesn't go any higher, I may risk 10 just to be conservative, 105.52. That's as far as I go, but I don't think it'll go any higher because this has negative volume right here, and the sellers seem to be coming in right now. Now, if this candle comes all the way down in, closes here or inside these previous candles, then at that point I know for a fact this is going to come down very aggressively. But right now that isn't the case, and again my stop loss will still be firm. So I want to see what happens here because we do have volume divergence. These two were inside candles inside this previous one. This one, of course, made that move, but it's negative. And we all know what a bullish candle with negative volume means. So at this point, I would anticipate this one to actually come down. If we are correct, it should be a very decent retracement. And since they are very far from the mean, this would be considered a mean reversion trade. Let's give it a second. Let's see how they play it. I won't risk more than 105.52. That's as far as I go. That would be the 10 pips. We'll see what happens here. So far, it seems like they're going to play it to the downside. Now, even if they came down to the first trend out, which is 105.23, that's practically a 20 pip trade. Wouldn't be a bad way to start the morning. Let's give it time to develop. See what they do. We have 2 minutes left on this candle. Good negative volume, but price action is not following through. Okay. In this candle is a must. We must see it come down. If not, then we have to exit. Seems like they're not ready to play this trade to the downside yet. Nope. Now I'll close the trade here. Hold on, let's see what they do. They come back down, but no. Now they're not ready to play the trade yet. We'll wait. They'll give us what we're looking for. This ain't over yet. This thing has to go up one more leg from the looks of it. That's okay. We will wait for it. Let's take a look at the pound dollar in the meantime. Since we are having the rate announcement tonight for the UK, we'll take a look at the British pound pairs. Should be interesting. Give it a minute. Okay, so this one's rallied to the upside, but it looks like it's playing to the downside now. Might be on time for this one. This one went up. You have negative volume coming across the board. And it seems like this may be it. This one has bullish volume, but it's been coming down. So I'm hesitant to go long. Don't have power dots here. But it looks like they're going to play it to the downside. Normally, I would wait, but in this case, this candle shows an imbalance where the sellers are not willing to sell any higher. Then this candle was a inside candle, and it one point went long and then ended up closing short below this, and this is a continuation. So this is usually where I would normally enter the trade to go down, to go short. So this must play out. If it does play out, then we should see it come down pretty strictly. But the next trend dot will form right about here at 132.36. So we actually need to see this trade come down 10 pips. Risk here would be 132.55, I'd like to say. But to be safe, 132.59. Everyone's expecting the British pound to rally prior to the rate announcement, but I don't think that they're going to rally. I think if they, right now, they would set up by going short first before going long, but we'll see. we'll see. This one should be an interesting trade here. Yeah, see, this failed. So at this point, I don't have a choice but to stick to my strategy and close my position to close my risk. We'll see what happens here. If it doesn't come back down, then we'll have to exit this trade. Maybe too soon right now. No, they're not ready to do anything. I'm going to have to be really, really cautious of the next trade now. Well, look at that. They're reacting too prematurely to the announcement. They already initiated this trade to the upside early on. Let's take a look on the 15 minute. Give it a second. Okay. Let's see this, since they're not playing it up, they fail to continue, but it's still not clear. They moved pretty aggressive from 131.13 to 132. To me, it's more considered what they call a big bend trade, but it's not clear yet. This is normally the candle pattern that we look for a reversal. So I'll re-enter it here. Stop loss based on entry will have to be 132.75, 10 pips. Can't risk more than that. Let's see what happens here. New candle. Starting to come down. Let's see. Let's see what happens here. I'll actually feel more comfortable when this trade comes back down to 132.54. Here it comes. Let's see. If anything, I would expect this to come right back down to 131.89 before the announcement. They were too aggressive in the move before the rate announcement. But we'll see if it gives us the trade that we're looking for. So far, it's giving us the volume divergence that we're looking for, and they did it prior to. So this is actually a good sign, because we're getting it right before this actually ended up playing out. So we should, if that is the case, then we should see this play out to the downside. Okay, come on. Let's go, let's go. Another 10 pips and we'll be back to break even. Actually, another 5 pips. Come on. I'm expecting it to do more. Come on, keep going. Let's go to the 10-minute. Yep. Give it a minute. Almost there. Okay, here we go. Okay, so we're right back to where we started. We're still positive in the trade, but I believe that this thing should come down right back to the mean, 31.89. This candle puts us back at break even based on the first two trades. Let's see if it continues. Still has 2 minutes left before it closes, but what a move on the first candle. One more minute left, and the next candle will be crucial. If it opens and continues down, then we should see it come down all the way down to 131.87. They may have overplayed themselves by moving prematurely before the announcement. Okay. This is not a good sign. Closing above the trend dot. This has to come down from here. It's a must, and it should reach this level, 132.18. If it doesn't reach this level, then we have to exit. Let's see how far this thing goes. So far, we're in the green now. Come on, come on. Calm down. At this point, if you got in on this trade, your stop loss, you should move it to 132.47 to lock in 20 pips. And then we're going to find one good trade. This thing's really, really playing out very nicely. Remember, 132.18 is the next level. If it doesn't go below that, then it's time to exit the trade. Be a little patient with it. Come on. Seems like it's not going to play. So at this point, I would rather lock in the profit. Let's see if it doesn't go below 132.30, which is a very crucial level for us right now. Nope, doesn't seem like it wants to go down any further. Come on, break below. Break below. The problem with this trade is that now this candle has bullish volume. They're holding and I'd rather just take what's on the table. 34 pips is not a bad trade. It allowed us to recover the 20 that we lost in the previous one going up and also recover 7 that we lost in the first trade and puts us in the green. So we'll have to come back to this. It seems like this is not over yet. But for the time being, it's over. I'm afraid that what will happen is that they'll come back up, retrace, and then fall further. See, now it's trading below 132.30. But there's a pivot right here at 132.23. So even if I wanted to re-enter this trade, I wouldn't do so right now. I would actually wait. Yeah, see, this candle needed to come all the way down here and didn't. So now it puts this trade in, makes it questionable. Makes the outcome questionable. Let's see if it continues. Right here is where they have a real issue with this pivot. Let's see. They came right to it, 132.23. And from this point, I don't have much confidence, and we already took profit on this trade. So, yeah, I think we're going to have to wait on this one. It came down pretty aggressive. after being so bullish, but if they hold from here, they could bounce right back up. We'll see. It ain't over yet. Look at that. You're gonna make that move even further. They could be ready to just collapse this thing. Come down quite a bit, but now starting to recover. So no, I think we'll wait on this one. Let's take a look at the pound Swissy. Something's happening there. Minute. Oh, look at that. Same trade. Right back to the mean. So here, question is, will it continue? That's the question. I'm not ready to go long because I don't have any signal indicating long, but I'm not ready to commit to another short trade. I may have to look at something else. Let's take a look at that Aussie dollar. Now that we're positive again, we have to wait. Let's give it a second, give it a minute. Okay. So this is the Aussie dollar. Now, this one already came back to the mean, came back up. They have power dots here, but we have everything indicating that they're going to take this long. At this point, I would not be short. It's already closed above this pivot, closed above this trend dot, and I like long. Now, stop loss based on entry is 5 pips. That's really what our risk is in this trade. But I think they're going to go right back up. Let's see what happens here. Seems like the buyers are starting to bring in the volume to the upside, but no price action. I'm still bullish here because we have volume divergence to the upside here. So it's directional. They initiated it here, and this is a continuation of that. So we should see it come up slightly further. I'd like to say another 10-15 pips to the upside. Let's see if it plays out. Nothing. We'll wait for this candle. If nothing happens after this candle, then we will move on. All right. Let's see what you're going to do now. Absolutely nothing. Should have popped. Should have gone all the way. Nothing. Still has bullish volume, but no liquidity, no momentum into this trade right now. I'm afraid that's where it's going to just stay. This current candle should have gone up. Let's see if it breaks above. No. Seems like it's not going to play. Would have done it by now. So it's time to exit. We didn't lose. We didn't win. We're at break even, but we're still positive for the night. Let us take a look at, actually, the euro pound would be very interesting to look at right now. Let's give it a minute. Let's see what happens here. Euro pound. Come on. Okay, this one has volume divergence, but my concern here is that they're retesting the trend stop and the mean, which in this case is the 200 and the 100. So I would not be looking for a long trade quite yet. We've missed this trade, but it initiated here. And I'm afraid that at this point, they're actually just going to attempt to come up and retest the trend stop and then come down. Right now, it hasn't done it, so we don't have a trade. We have to wait. We do have volume to the upside, and it is systematic. However, at this point, they're sort of stalling. And this is the reason why. So I want to see what the next candle does. And we got 2 minutes left on this particular candle. So we don't have a trade here, but could be setting up for one. Let's give it some time. Yeah, see this? See how it didn't go and break above this third trend dot? That's very crucial. It did go here. So wherever it closes here, if it closes here, right below that, then the next candle should be negative and come down. So we'll see. It's still... still pending. They haven't made a decision quite yet. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. That next candle down. See, at this point, the reason why they're not going to go up any further is because they were attempting to retest the trend stop, failed. This one closed here right below the third trend dot, didn't really make it all the way up, and so now we should see this thing come down from this point. Whenever they do a reversal, they have to reach a certain level, and once they break to the third trend dot, if they don't break above it, usually that is the end of their trade, and they'll usually do that very close to a moving average or a train stop as they're attempting to come back up. And after that, it's down, down, down. So this trade, we'll see how far this thing comes down. So far it's 10 pips. No. Here's the other thing. Once they do this reversal, then it must break the first trend dot here, which is 83.95. This is a must at this point. If it breaks below it, then we should see it come right back down all the way. And then that will make it a very favorable trade. And that would be our second favorable trade of the morning. So let's see. This should get interesting. Now we are practically 10 pips positive in this trade. Come on, keep going. Keep going. You're young. Very nice. This should be a nice trade to the downside. At this point, because they are setting up for the rate announcement, we still don't know which way they're going to go. I'm still not convinced that they're going to strengthen the pound further with the rate announcement, or they're going to try, but this would really, really be going to extremes at this point. So let's see how far this trade goes. If it gives us 200, I'm pretty much out at that point. Let's see. Come on, keep going. You've got a lot of room to go down. Volume is good to the downside, 49 million. But this candle is really young. It's only 4 minutes into it. On this 10 minute. So if it doesn't go down any further, I will probably exit. Okay, let's see. Very nice trade. Looks of it, could move down 25, 30 pips. Okay, we are heading down there. Let's see how far it goes. Because the next pivot is all the way down there. And they did do a very good job of retesting the moving average and almost testing the trend stop. So I would expect it to come down further. Come on, keep going. Seems like they don't want to go down any further from here. Was a good trade though, I have to admit. I think it's time for us to exit. Yep, it's time to exit. Not a bad trade. Let's continue. Pound Aussie. Let's take a look at the pound dollar, see what it did. So now we're up 35 pips for the night after initially starting off with negative 27. So we made those back. We made the negative up and are now positive 35. Let's see where we go from here. Maybe we find another trade. I'd like to see if we close with at least 40 or 50 pips. Okay, pound dollar. So came down, held, bounced right off the trend stop, and we closed it up here. Looks like they're interested in going back up, but not quite yet. I'd say they're interested in continuing down based on this, but we don't have enough proof at this point, so this trade is still questionable. Don't have anything yet there. Let's look at that US yen trade. That was the one that really did us wrong on the first one, but let's see where it's at right now. Give it a minute. Okay, give it a minute, we're almost there. Okay. Seems like this one's ready to come down. It wasn't before, but right now looks good. Yeah, I actually like this trade to the downside. Risk would be very minimal at this point. Entry 105.51. Risk would be 105.61. So you're looking at 10 pips of risk and the potential of this coming down at least to the trend stop, which would be 105.20. Let's see if it plays. We do have volume divergence, so I did look at that prior to taking the leap here. You can see how the dashes are settling closer to the 50% line. Even though this is an inside candle, it's still negative. This one is normally the candle pattern that we look for, settled negative, so this one must be a continuation of that trade. And prior to this, we did have volume divergence here as this went up. And that's what I was looking at, but we got in prematurely here and got out here with like a 7 pip stop loss in the first trade. So now this trade looks like it's set up to come down from this point. And if it does, we should see a very good trade. Now, I have a problem with this particular trade setup. Not that it's not going to play out, just that I did not expect dollar weakness to set up before the rate announcement. So we'll see if this trade actually follows through. And if not, then we'll have to basically close it out and be done with it. But it looks like they are getting ready to come down. It has all the elements for a short trade. See, this one here pretty much announced that the sellers were not willing to sell at a higher price, and so we saw them come down, but now they retested, failed. This settled below the previous two levels here, initiating a new level, and now this one should be the moment where they play it down. And if it does come down here, then it would come exactly to down the three trend dots that I'm looking for. So let's see. Here it comes. Break even, it has to play. At this point, it has to play to the downside. The only thing we're missing here are power dots, but we have everything else. We do have volume divergence. We have the candle pattern that we're looking for, the retest which failed, and from this point, we should have our trade. Here it comes. Let's see how far they play it. Come on, play it down. They're really taking their time. Should expect it to come here to 105.26. Let's see how far it goes. Give it some time. Nothing yet. Everything still looks good, so this next candle in the next minute should define for us if they're going to play the trade out or not. Come on, keep going. All right, here it is. Let's see, what are you going to play? If it continues to the downside, we are solid. If not, then we have to exit, but it looks good to the downside. Come on. Play the trade. Still looks good, got negative volume. Let's see, data box. Looks good, but we need more price action. We need price action to follow through. I mean, it opened up right where we wanted it to at the close of this candle, so we should see a continuation to the downside. And again, I'm not expecting it to go far, but I am expecting it to come down at least to 105.23. Come on, play the trade. Play the trade. Comes. Come on, play it. Play the trade. Say patience is a virtue, but they're really testing our patience right now. And they have a ton of volume in this candle right now. So I'm shocked that this thing hasn't come down any further. Seems like they're not ready to play the trade yet. They would have played it by now. Still isn't over yet, but it's not ready. Okay, we're up 10 pips. Let's see how far this goes. I'm looking for 20. That's the trade that I'm looking for here. If it gives more, great. If not, then it doesn't matter. Come on, play the trade. There's no news driver, so it's a straight robotic trade. Come on, keep going. Make the move down another 10 pips. Five more pips down. Come on, almost there. I would expect them to come down at least and try and attempt to retest the trend stop here at 105.25, potentially 105.30. It doesn't seem like they want to play it. Has negative volume, but not enough at this point. One more minute left in this candle. And it looks like they're going to use a trend stop as a support level. They didn't really come down to it, which is something that bothers me because they should have come down to it. We're going to have to exit the trade. One more minute left. Let's see what this next candle does. Okay, new candle. This one closed below the trend dot, so this one must define for us now. If it doesn't define to the downside, then we're out. Let's see the volume here. So far, so good. Very negative, but price action's yet to play out. Now seems like they're not going to trade it. That's a crying shame. The whole setup was there for it. It is what it is. We move on to the next trade. Let's check out that pound dollar, see what it's doing. minute. Okay. All right, so they didn't play it down. They didn't really play it up. Right now, we don't really have anything here to determine direction. Everything is to the upside. This thing closed above this, but as it came up, 1, 2, 3 did not make it. So this thing looks like it's going to come right back down. I like down. Risk would be 5 pips on this trade, actually. Entry is at 132.21, 10 pips. If it closes below this pivot, then it's a sure thing to the downside. Otherwise, we're risking. I won't risk more than 8 pips on this trade. That'd be as far as it goes. Let's see if it plays. They may not do much because they may be waiting for the rate announcement. So if anything, whatever they're going to do it now. Otherwise, we're going to be waiting for quite some time before they decide to. Down 1 pip. Nothing. 4 more minutes left in this candle, but no reaction. They may not do much until the raid announcement from this point on. Now, it does not seem like they're going to play this trade out. It's right at that pivot. See, for an inside candle, even though it has bullish volume, this thing should have gone already, and it hasn't. The volume here has been very, very choppy, very disorganized. No, no trade. Better to close out and not be exposed. This isn't ready yet, but let's look in the higher time frames and see if it's getting ready to define a specific direction. Give it a minute. See what's going on here. Here we go. So here on the 60 minute, they did go up, they came down. We've been playing it here, but nothing. Everything indicates long at this point. Volume is directional to the upside from here up. It initiated here, so everything was in line. But now it's stalling. It did go up, came down, settled below the power dots, which is never a good sign, even though it's been challenging. And so now this becomes questionable here, whether they sustain this level or come down from it. For all intents and purposes, I'd like to say that they're going to make a move to the upside first before coming down on the announcement, but I think that at the end they may play it to the downside more than to the upside. Let's look at the 240 minute. Good minute. Okay. Let's see. Let's remove that data series. I need to see with clarity. Okay. So they failed to close above the third one, which is normally a no-no, and it doesn't matter what level it's in. And if this thing comes below 132.17, 132.11, then at that point it's all downhill. Everything indicates that they're going to the upside, but I think that they may come up and retest the trend stop before coming down. I don't think that they're going to rally this based on the announcement today. So it'll be it's a very, very questionable trade right now. I'm not saying it could swing one way or the other. I'm more bearish on it than I am bullish at this point. Let's see what the 5 minutes says real quickly. Okay, let's see. Minutes, that's long here, and does look like they're going to play it up, but I think because they're going to set this trade up to go short later, so let's see how far they take it. They closed above this, if they closed above this pivot here, then they should come up right back to it. So everything indicates up. They had volume divergence here, volume was directional, and then continued here, may pick up a few pips. I'm looking for 10 pips on this trade. I'm not really looking for more. Let's see if we get it. No, seems like they're not gonna give us the trade. Wow. I would have expected them to actually go and break above this level here, and didn't do it. And this, if it closes below, then this would be the retest, and that means they'll come down from this level. No, not a good trade. They actually pulled us in, pulled me in very nicely on this one. I was expecting them to rally, and they didn't. The trade is no longer to the upside. It's actually to the downside. What a deceptive move they did on me. Yeah, this is a reversal. It's going to come right back down. Minutes left, and it looks more bearish than it is bullish. Nope. The trade is to the downside, not to the upside. They could come back up and retest. So in this case, nothing above 132.49. I don't think they'll come up beyond that. And then it's a straight trade to the downside from this point. Yeah, see, they played the trend stop, came down, retested it, went up slightly, and then came right back down. The trade is to the downside. If this candle closes below 32.18, this thing should, at this point, come right back down to the mean, 31.89, one more time. And I actually think that they're really going to bring this down from this point on. This could be the trade that we're looking for overnight, even with the rate announcement. I don't think that they're going to drive that thing up. I think they're going to drag it down. So now more or less we're almost at break even based on the trade that we made here. Anything from this point down is additional. And see, at this point, knowing that they actually are going to come down, you could actually add a second position. Because more than likely they will play it down. Let's see how far this goes. The first target in this one is actually this pivot here, 132.04. But if it breaks below that, then it should be a frenzy to the downside. And it could be a good 50-80 pip run down. Come on, keep going. Play the trade. Okay. Pivot formation. Let's see from here what happens. Nope, seems like they're not going to continue down, even though they should. See if they play it from here. Come on, play the trade. Gotta come down to 132.04. Come on, play the trade. No, they are having a liquidity issue right now. It's just like they're holding on to everything. All right, there's no pivot here, so you gotta come down and make that move. Come down to the pivot, 132.04. Keep going. Another 6 pips. You hit our mark. Keep going. No. Seems like they're gonna wait. And we're at the tail end of this, so might as well just close what's on the. Let's see. Next candle. Come on, if you're gonna do it now, but I don't like the volume to the upside now. No. It's better to take what's on the table and move on. Not a bad trade, but didn't play out to the next level that we were expecting it to. And so that's it for tonight. I don't expect the pound to actually increase in value at the rate announcement. I think that they're going to bring it down. So it'll be an interesting trade tonight. Alrighty, have a good one. Thank you for joining us today, and we will see you Friday morning. Thank you, and have a good night. Bye-bye now.